Hey, what's up? I'm Ryan, and today I'm going to help you better understand what the visibility functions are inside Blender, and maybe why you should be using them if you're not already. Also, just a quick note, I've not released a video in a while as I recently moved house. I've basically been living in a building site for several months, but that's coming to an end. So I thought I'd start making videos again. So with that out of the way, sit back, relax, and let's get to it. So the way I decided to configure my tutorials is by starting with the theory side of things, then move on to the practical. If you just want the practical elements, skip to the time on screen. If you decided to stick around, it either means you're a beginner or you just want a better understanding of what the visibility functions are. Either way, I'm glad you stuck around as I believe the theory section is actually way more important because that's where you learn your fundamentals. And because they're fundamental, the information is transferable to other pieces of software. So toggling visibility is exactly as it sounds. You have the ability to toggle the visibility of an object. And not to complicate things, but there are multiple types of objects, such as mesh, lights, cameras, and so on. And they all have this visibility feature. A quick example of where you'd use toggle visibility would be if you had a project that was beginning to get a little overcrowded, you could simply hide any object that you weren't working on. That's a very basic example, but you get the gist. I find it most useful when dealing with complex models that consist of multiple elements. You can simply hide any of those elements until you're ready to deal with them. I use the visibility feature in pretty much every project 100 times over, so I'd say it's pretty essential. As you can imagine, there are many situations where toggling visibility would come in useful, such as modeling, texturing, and wrapping, to name a few. You can also toggle visibility on a global scale, meaning hiding an entire type of object. But I'll get into object types later in this video. So now that you have some idea of what the visibility function is and what it could be useful, let's head over to Blender and get started. So we're in Blender with the default scene. Now, say if we wanted to edit this box and we wanted to hide everything else in the scene. We can do that by simply selecting the object we want and hitting the forward slash key on our keyboard. And as you can see, it's done two things. It has temporarily zoomed us in to our object, and if we scroll out here, you can see it's hidden the other objects in our scene. So it doesn't just hide geometry, but it also hides lights, cameras, and other types of objects. So if you hit the forward slash key again, it'll return it back to the way it was. You can also select multiple objects together. Either hold down the left mouse button and drag it over the items you wish to select, or simply hold shift and with your left mouse button, select your objects, then release the shift key and hit the forward slash key once again. Okay, great, let's hit the forward slash key to return it. Now, if you want to solo an object, but you don't want to change your view, you can select the object you wish to solo and hit shift H. And to return it back to normal, hit alt H. When working on a project, you may need to hide singular objects in your scene. You can do that by selecting it and hitting the H key to hide it. You can also select multiple objects like we did before using the shift click method or the box select method. And once you have it selected, hit the H key to hide it. And once you've made your changes, use Alt H to unhide all. Now, if you're not a fan of using shortcuts or just can't remember them, I suggest making some kind of document to keep track of them because Blender can be very shortcut heavy. However, for those who want a non-shortcut alternative to hide objects, you can simply go to the View Layers tab to the right here and select this eye icon. Okay, so as I mentioned at the start of the video, I have an alternative global method for toggling visibility. It's a very useful feature that I feel gets overlooked quite often. So I've just duplicated this cube here to better explain how this tool works. So let's take a look at it. So you can see here we have this large list of object types. We have mesh, curves, armatures, lights, and all that good stuff. So the object type visibility menu actually has two features. The first allows you to hide all of the objects of a specific type of object. So for instance, we have these cubes here. A cube is a mesh object. If we open up the menu and select the eye next to the word mesh, you can see it's hidden both of our cubes, or all of our meshes. They'll still appear in our renders, but they're hidden in the viewport window. So let's put that back by selecting it again. The second feature can come in quite useful. I'll show you how it works. So if we go back to the menu here, you can see this arrow cursor to the right of the visibility icon. Now, if we press it, it appears like nothing has changed. However, what's actually happened is you've disabled the ability to select mesh objects. As you can imagine, this is very useful for things like adjusting lights or cameras without accidentally selecting or moving models within your scene. Or say, for instance, you're happy with your lighting setup and you want to make sure you don't accidentally move your lights. Well, you can come back to this menu and disable the ability to select your lights. This ability is also accessible through the View Layers tab over here. It may not appear on your list by default, but if you come over here to this filter menu and select the same icon, which is this mouse icon here. Now, if we move our mouse off the menu, you can see that we have a new mouse icon, which again will allow us to individually disable the ability to select our objects. So, if you found this video helpful, feel free to give it a like, and if you have any questions or run into any issues, leave a comment down below and I'll try and help you out. That's all from me. I'll see you around.